Hi, my name is Amanda Torres, and today I'll be talking about IKEA and their unique supply chain. Most people know IKEA as that store where you build your own furniture, but why do they do this exactly? Today I'm going to go through what makes IKEA's supply chain so unique. I have split up my presentation into three sectors: sustainability, their cost efficiency, and how their retail stores and warehouses are one entity. The first unique factor of IKEA's supply chain that I'd like to talk about is sustainability. From the production of their products, their packaging and transportation, and even giving back to the environment, IKEA does an amazing job at keeping their business sustainable. One great example of this is in their production. If there are any leftover materials from one product, they'll find a way to use it for another. The next example involves packaging and transportation. IKEA ships products, for example, watering cans, so they're easier to stack and can be shipped in fewer trips. Same goes for the build-it-yourself furniture. Because the items aren't already built, this allows IKEA to package their items in flat boxes that are easily stacked. These are prime examples of how IKEA cuts down on CO2 emissions by making their truckloads lighter and having fewer trips. The final aspect of sustainability that I wanted to talk about has to do with them giving back to the environment. Being a furniture company, IKEA uses a lot of wood, but it has pledged to grow at least as much wood as it uses by 2020. I personally think this initiative is really cool because it's important that big companies like IKEA remember how much of an impact they can make on the environment. The things just mentioned led me to think about strategic sourcing and what we learned about this during the semester. As the book says, a company needs to manage their external resources to support their long-term goals, and this is what IKEA is doing with these different activities. Although the aspects within sustainability that I talked about aren't the only initiatives IKEA takes to keep their business sustainable, I think they are key examples of how they have an amazing environmental management system. The next unique factor within their supply chain is their cost efficiency. Although I mentioned the do-it-yourself packaging and sustainability, I want to look at it from a different angle. Because the furniture they sell is not already built and shipped in flat boxes, they are able to ship more in fewer trips. Although companies may use many different ways to be cost efficient, this is the one that made IKEA unique and makes them stand out from other furniture companies. This aspect is also reflected in their prices. When IKEA saves money by having a cost-efficient supply chain, it saves us as consumers a lot of money too. The typical consumer may not be able to pinpoint exactly why IKEA can make their prices so low, but after doing research, I can tell you that their cost efficiency plays a huge role in their supply chain model. The last unique aspect of IKEA's supply chain that I want to talk about is that their warehouses and stores are one entity. By day, you have customers roaming around trying to find their products in the warehouse, and by night, you have forklifts driving around trying to replenish everything that was sold. Cost per touch is a huge thing to IKEA. This means the less people who touch it, the less likely there are to be costs incurred. With this belief, it really does come in handy that IKEA customers pick up their products right from the warehouse. Based on sales in a day, a warehouse manager can forecast what they need replenishment in and what they need to order. This is known as demand management, and this is definitely simplified when the warehouse and the store are one entity. I have now gone through what exactly makes IKEA so unique. From their sustainability, their cost efficiency, and their warehouses and stores as one entity working in their favor, IKEA really does a great job at managing their supply chain. There are so many factors that go into a supply chain that if you get a little creative and innovative with it, it can go a long way.